Hey guys, Pallavi Sareen back on Kashmir Times Live. Today I have been introducing you to the sports stars in Jammu and Kashmir. And right before now we had a conversation with Shweta Thakur, a judo player, an international judo player, who talked about how the state government, instead of supporting the sports persons in Jammu and Kashmir, were actually putting an end to their careers by not providing proper equipment. And today I have with me Palak Kour, Bijral, an international gymnast from Jammu and Kashmir, who has kind of a similar story right before inter university, where she is playing from Chandigarh, not from Jammu and Kashmir. She has a foot injury. So Palak, how much in pain are you?
I'm in a lot of pain right now. Actually, I got a muscle tear right before my competition, and my competition is on 17th. Yeah, and it's been 2 weeks. I'm on bed rest, so it's awful.
And the Khelo India competition is also going to be held. So is it going to be problematic for you having that muscle there?
After this inter-university only, the selection has been done from here only. And from this only, I'll be selected for the Khelo India University. Obviously, I have to do it. I'll do it. That's not the problem. But the thing is about the facilities, of course. And we cannot hide those problems, because it's been so long, so many years, we have been asking for the facilities. So
yeah, that brings the question. How did you actually get this injury?
So it was basically the facilities, as I've told earlier. As I've told earlier, it's all because of the facilities in MS Stadium, Jammu and Kashmir. Mm-hmm. Actually, my foot, it got, under the mat, and I fell very badly. So it's been, like I told, it's been 2 weeks and I'm on bed, and I hope.
What did the doctor say?
Yeah, he told me that the foot, because of so many times my foot has been sprained and sprained all over again. So he told that my foot has now become very weak. So now
that's going to be harmful for you in your entire gymnast career, right?
Actually, that's true. Because in our game, we do it on our toes. Actually, it's like totally on our toes. Mm-hmm. So I can't even stand right now, and I have to do it on toes. So that's the biggest problem. But I know I can do it. But the thing is, please provide us with some facilities.
So the only request you have for the state government is please give us those mats. Yeah. It is kind of the same story like Shweta Thakur said. Yeah. Same thing happened with the faulty mats, and
yes,
she got a neck injury, which is most important for her for judo,
yes,
and you got
a
foot injury, which is most important.
Yeah.
Actually, how did you get into this gymnast thing?
I was 5 years old. I was just roaming in MS Stadium with my father and my sister. My sister used to do mm-hmm. skating. So my coach, he saw me. I was very lean and perfect body for gymnastics. So he told my father to put me in gymnastics. In the beginning, I was just doing it for fun. But gradually, I started gaining interest. Then I went for training. Then I played so many nationals. And then that's how it started.
So you were just 5 years old and you already got started with gymnastics. When I was 5, I was probably figuring out which food to eat. So high five on that. Awesome. How did the journey go from there? What happened afterwards?
I've told everybody, nobody knows about my coach. That is the biggest thing I don't like about my state. That
who's your coach?
She is the youngest Arjun Awardee of the country. Her name is Krupali Patel Singh. So I just want...
Krupali ma'am, hi.
Yeah. So people should know about her, because she is such a big celebrity. She should be. And nobody even knows... There's nobody in Jammu who has ever gotten Arjun Award. Mm-hmm. And she's the first one. And then I got under her training. First, I used to do just for fun. Wasn't under her training. Then gradually, I was 8 years old. Then I went for my training. Then nationals, I played so many nationals under her training.
Mm-hmm.
Then I played my first international. I was 11 years old.
Wow.
I went to Children of Asia. And that was my biggest, I played for India for the first time. And I can't forget that memory, because that was my first international and such a huge competition.
Mm-hmm.
So I played for that. Then I played more nationals. I've played, I don't remember how many nationals I've played.
Okay.
Then I played World Cup, Asian Games, Asian Championships, World Championship, and then Commonwealth Games. And people should know that in gymnastics, only me and my senior, her name is Mithali, we have played Commonwealth so far. and the people don't even know about it. So that's very shameful.
When you came back from that, all these international games and from Commonwealth, there must have been a huge party at home. So that reminds me, ki, are your parents actually supportive of whatever you're doing? Or are they much into ki, do academics, do good in studies?
Yeah, totally. My parents, especially my father, from the beginning, he was the only one who put me in the game. First of all, so also my mother, they both are so supportive. I am so lucky to have got such parents and as well as my coaches. So overall, very, very grateful to God.
What about your friends? Do they feel like they're amongst a star when they see you coming back from all these international games? Do people in Jammu actually stop you on the streets and be like, hey, this is an award winner. She's pretty awesome.
Yeah, people recognize. Some people recognize. They take selfies. It feels really good. But my friends, they are very supportive. My school friends, they are my friends till date. Then my college friends, everybody's very supportive. I've never been into any negative, surrounding. Never been into. Everybody has been very positive.
What about your schools and colleges? Have they been supportive sending you to these competitions and else?
I used to study in Presentation Convent School. So they were never supportive about my game, never. So they always used to, be negative. Only place that was negative were the senior people, like the adults. They were negative. The school, the college, these people never supported. And especially for Jammu, I used to study in women's college. So they didn't send me for 2 years for the inter-university. So that's why I migrated to Chandigarh.
Did they give a reason why they were not sending you to?
Nothing, no.
No reason?
We used to tell them. For first year, we missed it. But the second year, we talked to them. They didn't say anything. So we also then left.
So
without saying anything.
Was there hesitance in sending you to these games? Was about ki, it's sports, there's no career in that? Or is it about ki, you're a girl, making you all firm about sports is not going to help out? Be focused on studies, do KAS, IAS, or get married?
Yeah, exactly. Talking about the girl thing, when I was a kid, I used to hear a lot about that. You're a girl and this and that. But I proved myself, then people also, they just shut their mouths. But before, they used to say that. I used to hear. I'll not take names, obviously, but it was very discouraging at first. But my parents, as I've said, and my coaches, they were so supportive. I didn't used to listen to them. So they were like, people always have problem with people who are going above them, their level. So then, after I went to colleges and everything, the thing about that, they didn't send me for the inter-university. I think it's because of the academics. They want us to focus on academic sports. They're like, kya karna hai sports karke? They're like that, negative mindset. So in India especially, the mindset is this only, as everybody knows, ki padhai karo, kya karna hai sports, ladki hai. So, but we never listened to them and we proved them wrong, obviously. And that is why we are here where we are. So
you're currently studying in Chandigarh, right? What are you doing?
I'm doing MA in psychology from there.
In psychology, and what was the reason you didn't choose Jammu? This thing that they prioritize academics over sports, or does the facilities in Chandigarh are better?
Both. Facilities are also good, and the sports, they are much more about sports. So actually, they called my coaches. They wanted me to be there. They wanted me to participate from their university. So how could I, deny such a big thing for me? So I just went there. And after that, in Jammu, there were a lot of, articles being posted on the social media and everywhere that I have migrated and all that stuff. It was a big issue by that time. But
so they didn't recognize you when you were playing for Jammu and Kashmir?
And when I went there, then it was a big thing for them.
A different state recognizes you and then it becomes a big issue.
Exactly.
Tell us about your first medal. How did that entire incident go? What was your feelings inside you? How old were you when you first got your medal?
I was 8 years old. I played nationals in Jodhpur. I went to Jodhpur, I remember. And I got 3 gold medals and I still remember. I cannot forget that, obviously. And but I skipped being the national champion that time. We have 2 competitions. The first competition I didn't do well. So, but next year again when I went for the nationals, I was then announced as the national champion. So that also I remember very well. So these two competitions were very important for me. And also when I went for Commonwealth Games, at that time also we have been through a lot. The mm-hmm. government, the, you know, nobody supported, but my coach, she has done it all.
You're being modest about all your winnings. You need to show off to people so they realize it's such a big deal. It's a big deal to get all those medals. How many medals have you gotten up until now?
50 plus.
How many golds?
I don't remember.
You don't even remember that many. And have you gotten many state awards recognized by Government of India or something?
Yes. I've got the Sheri Kashmir Award. Mm-hmm. Then I got the state award that I have not got yet. And it has been 4 years it has been announced and have not got. And also in Chandigarh, I forgot to tell you, in Chandigarh, the president came and he gave us, he honored me with cash and with the memento also. So he has also honored.
So the president has honored you and yet the state government doesn't recognize you as a fantastic gymnast.
And because of Chandigarh, mm-hmm. I got that honor. So, you know, Jammu people, they got real, you know.
Where's the media now? Where's the media now? That is why she shifted to Chandigarh, because the state government was not recognizing anymore.
Yes.
Let's talk about academics now. How hard is it coping up with academics while you're doing the sports? Do you think about sticking to your sports and gymnast, or do you want to shift your careers and become like academic, more academic?
I want to talk about my school time, because during school time only I've played many internationals, and at that time I told you that my school was not supportive. So I used to go for training in the morning and evening as well. So I was selected for the Commonwealth Games. That happened in Delhi, if you remember, in 2010. Yeah. At that time, I was underage, so but I was in the camp. So I used to go. I was in Delhi for the camp. So I had my pre-boards. So the school was, I can't even say that. They were so unsupportive that they called me fourth in back. They called me to give my exams for pre-boards. They could have waved off. Yeah. So they called me, I came, I gave my exams, and then I flew back and came and gave exam, like, you know. And then I got good marks. I got like 80 something marks. And the principal was like, how? How did she get so much marks? She was, you know, questioning the teachers. Actually, that happened. But then it's okay, everything.
How were your parents through all of this, with you flying back and forth, someone supporting you, someone coming with you, or were you doing all of this on your own?
My coach, she came with me. My parents, they just supported me, but everywhere I have been, it's with my coach only.
So coaches have been like your second family.
They are like, I want to say that they are equal into my parents, I think above them, because they have made me what I am today, and it could have not been possible ever. If she has struggled so much for me, she has left her kids for me, you know. So that's a very big thing for me. Yeah.
What about, you know, these facilities in Jammu and Kashmir that you talk about? Have you done something for it? Have you written applications, talked to the governor, or actually made pleas for getting more equipments or something? The things that they should be doing on their own, but have you made an effort to do something?
Yeah, it's been 16 years. I'm 22 now. I've been doing gymnastics. And all these 16 years, we have been asking for only one thing, that please give us the mats, please give us the infrastructure. And, you know, since till now, nothing. Mm-hmm. And like I told you about this injury, it's because of those mats only. The mats are for 25 lakhs. And they can't give us that. I don't know what more they can do for us. We have proved ourselves. We have played every international competition, all World Cup. I don't know. Only Olympics we have not played. And that's only because we need the infrastructure. Mm-hmm. If you give us that, we can play that also. And I want to say one more thing. While the Commonwealth Games, we didn't have the hall also. We used to practice in the... have you been to MS Stadium?
Yeah.
There's the ground you have seen outside. Mm-hmm. We used
the
to practice
ground.
There. No. Yeah, that's out there. We used to practice there.
Gymnast used to practice there without any mats and without any floor.
Yeah.
You got many injuries at that time as well?
Exactly. I've been... That's injured countless times.
But still you seem like in good shape apart from that injury in your foot, of course. So what is your daily schedule like? You wake up, you go to the gym, you handle everything from your diet and everything?
Yeah, I go to stadium at 5:30. I train, then I come back, then I go for at 4 again, then till 9 p.m. we are there. So it's like, I can't do anything without, you know. Also with the pain, with the injury, I'm going. So I don't think my life will ever be complete without this.
But your sports life seems quite hard than a normal 9-to-5 yes. job. But still you want to stick to it.
Yes, obviously. It's like it's my passion. It's like, you know, addiction for me. So
what's your future plan like? What do you plan on doing?
That I don't talk about much, but I have thought about opening an academy. I don't want to do those mainstream things, you know, like everybody has given their lives playing and then they go for railways, for this and that. I just want my career to be this, my game that I've been playing since so long, since I was a kid. So that's what
I'm... So you want to turn your passion into your career choice, yeah. And you'll probably have good maths there, right?
Yeah, obviously.
That is the first thing that will be on your mind. So thank you so much for talking to us. And this was a great conversation. All the best for your inter-university. Hopefully you'll recover by then. This was Pallavi Sareen On Kashmir Times.